Hello everyone, my name is Soaring Brad, and I'm here to bring you a video on Bioshock 2. Bioshock 2 was a game released in 2010 by 2K, and is the sequel to the big hit game Bioshock, which is why it has the 2 in it, because it's the second one. And this game decides to take a different route from the first one. In the first one, you were playing as a human who was trying to survive in Rapture and make his way out. But on your journey through, you had to fight the big daddies and splicers. But in this one, you get to play as a big daddy. And now you gotta make your way out by fighting other big daddies and splicers. Now this is what a dad bod should be like. And now that you know that you're gonna be playing as a big daddy, you're probably wondering, does that mean I have to watch after the little sisters? Why, yes you do. You'll have to care for them and watch them as they do their questionable habits. Bloody hell there, don't let the neighbors see you do that. You know how hard it is to find a good place in this inflation. Okay, that was just creepily adorable. And you're probably wondering, since you're the daddy, that means there's gotta be a mommy as well. And there is! And she's
This is not your daughter. Do you understand? Her name is Eleanor, and she is mine. Take the pistol. Place it against your head. Fire.
Yeah, I'm gonna be honest with you, she's straight up a bitch. And then you happen to see the Bioshock 2 logo appear, and your thought is, wait a minute, I just took a bullet to the brain, and I'm not playing Fallout New Vegas, so I should be dead. Well, you're not, and there is a story behind that. I'm gonna do my best not to reveal too much of the story as I talk about this game, because the story really does help with the immersion. But you've been dead for some time, and now you're back and alive and kicking, and I imagine you have a massive headache. And as you look around, you notice that everything has completely changed. The once bright and vibrant city is now dark and flooded, covered in all kinds of damage, and also covered in sea vegetation. And I would like to say the creators of this game did a damn good job with their level design and atmosphere, because the game looks downright gloomy in areas where it needs to be, but yet still at the same time be beautiful to look at. No matter where I went, I would just pause and take a look at all the rooms and all the areas just to see what was around and see how great the levels really were. The amount of work they put into this was just amazing. And you really get blown away when you see the level of detail they put into it whenever you start walking around underwater. Don't get too excited though. When you go underwater, everything's set on a linear path, so you don't get to do too much exploring, and it's not for very long. But the world around you just looks amazing. And unlike the first game, you can actually see the damage that was going on the outside of Rapture, not just the inside. And now that you're playing as a big daddy, you probably think there's not much for you to be worried about, because in Bioshock 1, the big daddies were very tanky and tough to take down. Well, not in this game. You're actually an early version of the big daddies, so you're not as strong and as tanky as they are, and you're gonna have to rely on your wit to get by. Even just the common splicers can be a challenge, especially when you get outnumbered. And yes, you can still use Adam, which helps you out a lot. And just like in the last game, you are able to upgrade your abilities, your weapons, and your stats in order to make the game easier and be more creative with how you take on certain situations. And you're really gonna need the upgrades because you're gonna have to start protecting the little sisters. You know, Rapture's a nice city, but I can't help but notice its high kidnapping rate. Seriously, the Bioshock stories revolve around kidnapping. Yeah, one of the new enemies in this game is the big sister. And just like Eleanor's mother, they don't want you around the little sisters. And don't let their thin frame fool you, they are powerful and will knock you around like you are nothing. The big sisters are not as common as the big daddies or the splicers. They mostly appear after you've either saved or harvested all the little sisters within a given area. So it's just like Bioshock 1, you have the choice to save or harvest, and it does affect the ending. And just as a little reminder, harvesting gives you more Adam, but puts you in a rocky relationship with them. Saving them gives you less Adam, but you do get little rewards here and there. And there's actually one different way you can gather Adam in this game. Just like in the first game, you can defeat the big daddy to get to the little sister, except now you are given the option to adopt and or harvest. And when you adopt, you are able to carry the little sister around with you just like the other big daddies, and you'll be looking for specific bodies that the little sisters will harvest Adam from. And after they harvest the Adam from the bodies, you are given the choice again to harvest or adopt again. Basically, the more bodies you harvest the atom from, the more atoms you get. And as the little sisters are gathering the atom from the bodies, you have to defend them at all cost. So the gameplay switches over to this defend the area kind of gameplay, and luckily you are given abilities and weaponry that help you out a lot with this. And once you start upgrading your powers and learning that a lot of them can be combined with each other to make clever traps, it is really fun to do this.
Daddy. I'm telling the other girl that I have the best dad.
Oh god, you have no idea how much I needed to hear that today. And now, let's talk about some of the other changes that have been made to the game. Starting off with the weapons. You do get new weapons in this game that are specific to the Big Daddy. Like the big hand drill that you see a majority of them carrying, you finally get to carry that. Starting off, it's very short range, but allows you to bash the enemy or drill through them. And as you go to upgrade it, you can increase the damage, fuel consumption, and also add elemental abilities to it. But my personal favorite is the charge dash. It's always so satisfying to get a hit with that. Now onto your range weapons, they pretty much receive the same upgrades. Increased damage, increased range, increased accuracy, that kind of stuff. And once you fully get them upgraded, you're able to add more elemental abilities to them. Like say a static shock. But just a heads up, if you're standing in water when that static charge goes off, you're gonna get shocked yourself. So be wary of where you're standing when using that ability. And now let's talk about your powers with the atom. Just like in Bioshock 1, you can upgrade the damage and the range of your abilities, but they did get a little bit more creative in this game. When you charge them, you actually get a secondary bonus with those abilities. Like a simple flick of your wrist can set someone on fire with the incinerate ability. But if you hold it down and charge it once you get the proper upgrade, you can charge it to the point where it'll actually cause an explosion on the enemy and affect everyone around him. And you can do this with other abilities. And one thing that's different from the first game, you can actually combine these abilities with one another. My personal favorite being the cyclone trap mixed with other elemental abilities. They did change how you have to hack a machine now. You have to use this little device that you aim at the machine, shoot at it, and hack it from that way. And instead of doing puzzles, you do this little quick time event where you have to land on specific colors in order to hack it. Which I didn't like at first, but it grew on me, especially when I realized that the entire world doesn't pause whenever I'm hacking. I have to choose a careful time to do this, so I have to be clever about when I choose to do it. Now, you don't have to shoot this device at every machine. Some machines you can still walk up to and hack. And some of the enemies did get a little bit of a change. The splicers in general are pretty much the same except for one, which is just a big tanky splicer who likes to throw things around and charge at you. He does provide a good challenge, especially when he's got his buddies with him. And some of the Big Daddies are similar, but there are two new variants. One being a Big Daddy that loves to use explosives, and one being a Big Daddy that is similar to you. They do provide a challenge and force you to rethink how you need to approach them. Some Big Daddies you have to be able to take down from a distance, other Big Daddies you're just gonna have to deal with them while they're up in your face. And now, is this game perfect? Well, no, it does have its flaws. Sometimes the enemy AI can be a little wonky. Sometimes you'll just see them constantly running into a wall instead of running after you even though they know you're there. Or sometimes they just don't notice you. But it didn't happen too much on my playthrough. Graphics are okay, but you can tell in certain areas where they decided to cut back on the level of detail. I imagine it was a way to save on resources and time. Because when looking out the windows into the ocean, you can see where they cut corners. It's not too bad, but it is noticeable. And I will say the story here is good, but it's not as good as the first one. And that is a very high bar to try to overcome right there. I will say about this story, some things did feel a little predictable, but at the same time, it still kept me on my toes wondering what was going to happen next. And I did enjoy picking up all the audio logs, trying to put the pieces of the story together, trying to make sure I understood it. But you want to know something I did not enjoy? This little flying bot right here. How is it I can destroy all the other ones, but I cannot destroy this one despite it being exactly the same as the others? All in all, I have to say this is a game that is worth checking out. I played this on the Bioshock collection for the PS4, and if you don't have anything to do and you want to have some fun with a good story, this is your game. And that's all I have to say. Have a good day.